over the last few weeks I have done a big job here in my milling machine using my fourth axis here. That is the one with the harmonic drive I built. I am really impressed by this one. It works really, really well. I can trust it for anything I feel. Stable as a rock. But the set axis has kind of deteriorated over the time here. At the time when I installed the linear scale on it, it performed very, very well. I could trust it down to the hundredths of a millimeter in height, but now it is not good at all. Let me show you. That, my friends, that is nothing you wish for your enemies. So where does that come from now? I don't know. It must be over here somewhere, at the slides, linear scales, ball screw. Let's check what the ball screw is doing. Oh, yeah, it obviously commanded that position. Stupid. I suspect it is the axis here that is really the only thing that can change over time. And I feel maybe a problem there. So I have to take that apart. Yeah, so that screw here, I think it is too far out. Okay, so there is a way to support it. I just need to make sure that all feedback has been switched off. And here is how to set that. P gain. D gain. And I gain. I have control over that one anyway. That's it. Now it should be passive, shouldn't bother with me, and I should be able to lift it up slowly here. I'll have to look at the axis here a bit. A lot of backlash there. Why is that? Here's another view. Nothing really interesting, but have a look here at that gap here. So that is what I wanted to look at. The lift with the jack and the gap is disappeared, and now I release the jack. See, that tells me anyway that the slideways, there is a lot of play in the slideways, so it all points to that screw that I had there. Okay, so this should be tightened then, but this one I made in an earlier video, you know that. I have to loosen up on the top side. Maybe I need to operate the jack here a bit. Yes, that is better. Then it comes up. Yeah. I may have to open the top one. I can probably save the video footage from this, and then I run a series here every 3 months, how to adjust the Z axis. That's a lot. How can that be so much? Feels almost wrong. I mean, how much have I screwed it up? I think I will have to try it there. Yeah, look at how much I have moved it. It is 10 millimeters or so. But it is well lubricated, so perhaps it can work. I will restore the feedback values and then give it a try. So back with the values, P gain is 30. Maybe I should just lower the jack. I'll do that. You're in two following error, of course, yeah. No. Okay, I can hear it is better, but not perfect. Let's check. So what did I do? I had fast forward here. Oh, it's much better. Yeah, it's much better. So I was touching the right parameter. But there was another thing I saw, and that was that claw coupling up here. Yeah, so... Put that off here. Not obviously bad. Tightened it up a bit more. Yeah. I think it's the right parameter. I can't bring it up too much though. To bottom out here. Yeah, up is almost better than down. But this claw coupling here... Oh my god. This claw coupling here is not really up to the job here. I'll see if I can replace that one. So I have to secure the... that axis again, so it will not fall down. That's it. So, switched off the feedback settings again. Need to grab this miniature screw here. There was some tension on it, wasn't it? And I can always take it apart anyway, because it's a claw coupling. Coupling here should work, I hope. Yes, it does. Yeah, it needs quite a bit of force here to clamp it down properly. There we have it, I think. Here's a pretty nice view. This is on the inside. This is where the ball screw meets the head. And if I pump on the jack a bit and release it, perhaps you can see something. Yeah, I don't think you saw that perhaps, but show you if I put my hand on it. There you can see. So this means that there is a screw that has come loose. And I think this is the root cause of this problem I have had now. Well, I guess every design here has its weak points. Let me show you where this screw is. Tension on it, and the final one. I don't intend to disconnect any of the cables, so I want to do this on the fly, so to say. There should be enough slack there. Maybe it is tightened up a tad too much. I found it should be all right. So the issue that is this screw here. This connects this saddle, or what you call it, to the ball screw, and yeah, I can loosen it by hand. So that is really the real problem. I can open it up. In one way it is just to tighten it again really hard. And I can use some threadlock. Doesn't seem to fit that good though. What can that be? So it's not really a problem, it is more like it is designed to slide there. Yeah, I can't do anything about that, I guess, but I can tighten down that screw as hard as I can. That is a M12, so it can take a lot of force. But some threadlock is needed there. So now when the slide here is loose, I guess I have to check how much I tightened these Gibbs screws here. I think I overdid them too much, really. No, not. Doesn't seem so. Or of course it could be that the way to tighten them is on the other way. Basic question, perhaps. But I think that was it, yeah. Yes! So all my work before that was to loosen it. No, I can't move it by hand. So, a few millimeter up and... yeah, now I can move it. Like that, it may be okay. Okay. But that can always be accessed afterwards. That is good. Now let's see here. So there is the screw. And I have some threadlock there. Seems to be threadlocking, right? So next time I guess I need to burn down the machine, because this will not loosen by itself. There it is. I'm not happy with that. Here is a long lever. Yeah, it's for the changing the wheels on the car. There is really a lot of tension. That gets loose again. Okay, I have to rephrase that. When that comes loose again, I have to do something else. Yes, I think that was sorted then. So, tight and firm. I can adjust the gib here afterwards. So that should be fine. I guess it's just to put it back then. Place one position, and if it is there, it is also locked here. Good. I can't find the last nut at this point, but it will show up later, sooner or later. I can fasten the head here without it, no problem. There it is. Oh. Yeah. It fell down. It will need to rest on the jack here. And there was the final order nut. Oh. There we have it. Oh. There you can sit. There it is. Now, let it rest on the jack. There we are. So even if the root cause now probably has been found and fixed, there is still the issue with the throw coupling. So I will see if I can add this one here. I will have to tighten that up pretty hard. There is as hard as I can do it, I think. And quite a bit better than before. Now there is a balance act. That's a drawback with big motors. And what about the length of the tubes? This could actually benefit from a redesign, I think. It doesn't seem to be the most sturdy design I have made. Let's see where we end up here, if there is some spaces needed in between there. I think it is needed. That's how it will be. I do the one here on the left side. For me it is on the left side. And the last one was dropped on the floor. Half of it. There will be a lot of cutting on this video. There will be a lot of editing. There, I think it is. I have to have some order in this. There's that one. Away with the tools. So, what happens now if I start Linux CNC here? Okay, it seems good so far. What? Shit. No, should not be. That should be okay. More than one way things can go wrong here. This is the encoder feedback from the linear scale for the z-axis. Obviously the machine has been moved around here too much, so it has crashed into the wall there. See if I can get it out. And see if I can save it. It wasn't so nice though. I'll just take a chance that it works right directly right away then. After the linear scale was reset, it all works fine now. So it's power on and zero axis set first. A bit of a vibration noise there. X, Y, and A. And there it is. So what happens now when we first crank up the speed? 3500 millimeters per minute, but it won't do that much. But so the axis seems to work very nice here now. If you recall the terrible vibration I had in the beginning, then that is all gone now. But this works fine. Great. Yeah, I think this is fixed. Yeah. Maybe I have enough footage to do this in 3 months again, but Yeah, for now I'm happy, this is working fine. If you follow this all the way here, thanks for watching.
Not so fast. It isn't ready until it is ready.
Could be. Yeah, I think that we'll have to do. And in this direction it is not perfect actually. Here it is 17 hundredths of a millimeter. Or 18. 17. That is not good. And just to see that it isn't a table that is warped in any way. Maybe a little bit, but not not 17 hundredths of a millimeter. Yeah, so is the head leaning or is it the axis that is leaning? So that was the distance I measured, was it 17 or 18 hundredths of a millimeter? And let's go down. Started on 3 there. But it came to about 10 there, so it is both, I guess. Now, so it seems that it is the axis that is mostly leaning, so 15 hundredths of a millimeter. But leaning axis I cannot deal with right now, I feel. Maybe in a later stage, but I'm not right now. Yeah, so it is leaning inwards, yeah. And with those final checks, the machine is back in working order again. Thanks for watching.